Get straight to the topic about the imaging of solid renal masses. So what are the differentials once we are looking at the solid renal masses? So they can be benign, they can be malignant, they can be metastatic, they can be lymphomas. Amongst the benign, the most common tumors which we encounter are oncocytomas and angiomyolipomas. And amongst the malignant, renal cell carcinoma is the most common cancer, and of which the clear cell pathology is again the most common pathology encountered. Ultrasound is the first investigation for any kind of suspicious renal mass. It is cheap and it is easily available, and the masses can be either single, they can be multiple, they can be bilateral, they can be cystic, necrotic, etc. We always mention the echogenicity of a mass and we compare the echogenicity with the surrounding renal parenchyma. And unfortunately, there is no specific echogenicity. So renal mass can be isoechoic to the renal parenchyma, hypoechoic, hyperechoic, anything can happen. Additional studies apart from the grayscale ultrasound are Doppler and contrast enhanced ultrasound, which may help to show the vascularity of this particular mass and may corroborate the diagnosis of a renal cell carcinoma. CT scan is presently the gold standard because it is so easily available, and also it's really easily decipherable by the surgeons. It has a sensitivity of approximately 95%. And as the size of the mass increases, the sensitivity also increases. So just one film would not be sufficient to delineate what kind of pathology we are dealing with. So we need a non-contrast film. We need a film with a corticomedullary phase. We need a film with a nephrogenic phase. And we also need a film at times for the delayed phase. So what are the features that we see in each of these studies? So in an unenhanced study, we are supposed to see whether the lesion has fat. So if the lesion has significant amount of extracellular fat, then unlikely that we are dealing with a renal cell carcinoma. We have to see calcification, which is more common in renal cell carcinoma and hardly ever seen in angiomyolipomas. We can see about hemorrhage, proteinaceous fluid in the unenhanced phases. Corticomedullary phase is the phase at which we see the vascularity of the tumor. And this is the phase which helps us differentiate a tumor from a pseudotumor, a pseudotumor being a dromedary sum for any lump in the kidney, which is physiological. In the nephrogenic phase, we are supposed to see the tumor more. The tumor is very prominent in the nephrogenic phase. We can also see the wash off, which again suggests vascularity of the tumor. And we can also look for the thrombus in the venous system. Excretory films are important if we are suspecting any kind of transition cell carcinoma. So this is a very simple protocol which you can follow while you are deciphering these CT scans. So first of all, in a CT scan, see whether the, on an unenhanced film, do we have a macroscopic fat present or not. If we have a macroscopic fat, we are actually dealing with angiomyolipoma. Then see the unenhanced films to the enhanced films, compare the enhancements. So if the enhancement is almost equivocal around the a level of around 10 Hounsfields, then it is like probably a low enhancing lesion and you might need an MRI to characterize this lesion. If you have an enhancement of approximately 20 Hounsfield unit, think of renal cell papillary carcinoma. And the other differentials, oncocytoma can be very similar to papillary as well as clear cell. So think about oncocytoma also. And in very rare instances, you can have a fat poor AML, which also stands as a differential in mild enhancement enhancing lesions. The third categorization is vivid enhancement. So the enhancement is more than 20-25 Hounsfield units as compared to non-enhanced films. And in this condition, think of clear cell renal cell carcinoma. The differentials, again, oncocytoma and minimal fat AML also remain. But the most likelihood is that you're dealing with clear cell renal cell carcinoma. The next modality which we deal with is MRIs. MRIs are generally used for determination of the cystic lesions and indeterminate solid lesions. These are very important studies in patients who have renal impairment, and the contrast cannot be administered to these patients. So there are various phases of MRIs, various sequences of MRIs which need to be studied once you are studying renal masses. The most important ones being the T1 weighted images, T2 weighted images, chemical shift images, and fat suppressed images along with contrast enhanced images. So I'll give you a very simple algorithm again, how to decipher a renal mass once you're given a MRI film. So first of all, as contrast to the prostate cancers in which T2 phases are more important, in renal masses, T1 phases are more important because T2 can show high intensity, low intensity, or iso intensity in renal cell cancer. So first of all, pick up a film which shows you a T1 phase film. So if you see macroscopic fat, in the sense that if the lesion is very bright and that indicates that there is presence of fat on a T1 lesion, think of angiomyolipoma. If you see on a T1 phase that the intensity is low, then it is probably because of intracellular fat. And intracellular fat is a characteristic feature of a clear cell carcinoma or a fat poor AML. Again, if you give a gadolinium contrast, then if the mass is very hypervascular, think of renal clear cell carcinoma. If it is not as vascular as that, then think of papillary carcinoma. Then look at the films in which you have intravoxal fat chemical shift images. So in these images, if there is intravoxal fat present, think of clear cell carcinoma and the second diagnosis being a minimal fat angioma lipoma. So I'll show you a few pictures. This is a mid-polar kidney cancer. You can see it out here. So this is a T2-weighted film. In the T2-weighted, slightly hyper-intense or maybe iso-intense. But again, the important film being T1. So if you compare it with the kidney, so this is a hypo-intense mass on a T1. Once the gadolinium contrast is being given, you see that the mass enhances significantly. It is even more enhancing significantly as the renal cortex. And in the nephrogenic phase, you see that there is a quick wash off. So this mass is a very vascular mass, and this mass is a hypo-enhancing mass on a T1. So most likely, this mass is a clear cell carcinoma of the kidney. Nuclear imaging, FDG PET does not have any much significance in the detection of a primary tumor, but yes, it can be used for staging as well as follow-ups. It can differentiate bland tumors versus tumor thrombosis, and it can also help you to assess the response after TKIs. There are recent advances in nuclear medicine in which we use CA19 antibody, which is more accurate for kidney cancers, and system EB scans show high uptake on system EB scans, and we can differentiate oncocytomas from RCCs based upon these scans. With this, I'll wrap up my presentation. Thank you so much for patient hearing.